In an interview with Urban TV shortly after commissioning of a multi-billion project funded by Government of Uganda, Opolot Okasai, the State Minister for Energy, revealed that they have a set a law that requires a person caught in the act of vandalism to pay 1 billion shillings or else serve 15 years in prison.
A law which is so punitive. If you are found stealing electricity, you are liable to paying 1 billion shillings, or you are imprisoned for a period not less than 15 years in prison, or both.
He also urged the general public to own projects provided to them by the government, as the local leaders take immediate supervision as a joint fight against the increased cases of electricity vandalism.
It's a very bad vice, and to avert vandalism, like I have commissioned this line, I'm handing this line to the local community. It is now their line. It is not a government line. They should watch the infrastructure which government has provided.
The commissioned project will see most villages of Bugoye and Ndugutu sub-counties be electrified for the first time ever since their existence. Godfrey Kabyanga, the State Minister for ICT and National Guidance, indicated that distribution of electricity among residents of the said villages is at set, although still halted by limited distribution lines.
The distribution lines are still limited. So that's why we are trying as much as possible to increase the coverage so that people can get electricity. But as soon as that infrastructure is in place to transport electricity, to distribute electricity, then everybody will be connected.
Soe Dikitanywa, the Member of Parliament of Songora North, where the project has been set, applauded the government for the continued service delivery, especially to the people hailing in rural areas.
To show our people that government is interested in what it gives the citizen. In the past, the leaders have been hijacking some of these government programs. Government gives people electricity, and the leader says, I am the one who has provided you this electricity.
Klemba Investment Limited is the company that will solely be responsible for connecting all the communities. Jane Birungu, the Chief Executive Officer, Klemba Investment Limited, pledged commitment for effective service delivery.
The role of Klemba Investments on this project, once the government has constructed the line, it is now officially handed over to us to operate, because we have an operations lease with the government of Uganda to extend the connections to the households, to the commercials, institutions, and all other social amenities.
Joseph Cooley, a resident of Katoke, say that this is a golden opportunity for them to set up a number of electricity-based businesses such as saloons, flour grinding machines, among others, hence changing their standards of living. Most villages in Kasese district, especially in sub-counties of Rukochi, Chitabo, Bugoye and others, remain without electricity because of vandalism of electricity equipment such as transformers, wires and poles. This has left many companies in charge of electricity installation stranded, hence the delay in ensuring rural electrification. Story compiled by Samuel Amanyire for the news.